Okay. Hello. And right, just getting organized. Right, so what am I doing? So what I was going to do first is basically copy some graphics from my Flickr, all the Lemming stuff. You can find here, which is all the animations. So I've copied that, and I have a level here, which we're going to use as the test, just for something to walk over. We'll make it a bit more friendly later. First thing, just get level up, Lemming walking about on it. That is the goal. Everything else will come. That'd be a good one as well. We'll maybe come back to that later as our level 2. This file's also got kind of masks and things you need for the different animations when you're taking stuff away. So I just have to try and remember how all this works. So let's stick over there. So first thing is we get our Lemmings animations in. Okay, there we go. So we'll use this and we'll copy from this into different things. So do Walker first. And actually, that last one is actually on jumping up. If you get a few more pixels, he kind of jumps up a little bit. And it's not actually part of the walk cycle. So copy these. Here should be fine. And what I should do is flip the black and then just take the black away. Be left with the Lemming. So just take this out. Life of a games programmer, cutting up graphics. All you seem to do. Frames. Another 1, 2, 3. Okay, so that's Walker. Let's just So the point for the lemming was always just under his feet. So as long as that was solid and nothing above, then you were standing on ground. I also want faller. Here. And then again, 4, 4, 16, 10. Where are 10s up? It's funny how I remember that size after all these years. Blink. Okay. And again, origin's kind of there. Do it. What was that? Fine. Okay, so now we need something to walk on. Now I do have this background that I had. And this will be interesting trying to fit this in properly. Actually, should have got it. Hey! Let's check this out. Hoorah! Alright, so this is a screenshot, obviously. We're just going to cut out these. Get to those in due time. Boop. Boop. Okay, now black's not used here. I wonder if. Hide. If you've not used the new layer stuff, it's awesome. Ooh, that works better. Like doing Lemmings enhanced, complete with parallax backgrounds. I'm also not quite sure how much of this I'll get done. The basics of just getting a lemming walking over the top of things is pretty straightforward. But the all the different skills, that would take quite a bit of time to get going. We'll just have to wait and see how far we get. So, a lemming's level was 5 screens wide by 320, which is 1600. That's on a 320 by 200 screen, so we shall make that the size of the room. Now ideally, I would like So the room would be200 by 200. Okay. And we'd need a view. Little views, clear background. Actually don't bother clearing background, that's a waste of time, we have a background. So we're gonna view it by 320 200. That's 3960 by 600. And maybe on that one. Okay, so that gives us our kind of view area that we're going to work with. I need to add our level. Not to that one, to this one. Okay. Initially, I'm not really fast. I should walk over this fine, so it's a decent test. Could do with the trapdoor graphic actually as an object, that would be good. So let's just copy this because we need something to spawn our lemmings. Gonna fill that in, just don't want it. Should die if it looks better like that. Okay. Trap door. Let's place the origin for that. Yeah, 42 3. Okay. And then we'll place one of them. You'll notice I prefix everything with O for objects, S for sprites, all that kind of stuff. It just means when you're reading code, it's clear what's an object, what's a sprite. Okay, so trapdoor. So let's just put trapdoor here. Stick a line in case they start moving left first. So that's what we'll see on the first screen. Okay. So just want to make sure my views are right. Hey, there we go. Now I'll have to do scrolling. I haven't actually used the new camera stuff at all yet. Okay, so let's start with a lemming. Now, level. So, lemmings walk over the top of backgrounds. They count up 4 pixels. And then they'll jump to the top of that. If it's any more than that, they'll turn around. This is how they manage to zigzag through this stuff. They'll come up here, jump through to there, they'll go there, and they'll jump up to here, so they kind of get through things. If that was a big, tall thing, I would kind of see that and then turn around. So on this, again, they'll just wander over this, which should be fine. But we need a way to get this into a mask thing that the processor can look at and use as a collision mask. This is where it's getting interesting. So, first things first. reset level mask. You shouldn't really do surface creation inside steps or crates or anything. It should all be in the draw, because that's when rendering set up on the first time you draw. So if you try and do it straight away, just it's not necessarily going to work. Level and int mask. Okay, so also because we're modifying the background, it has to be on the surface. And so. Surface. That should be minus one. Never create a surface minus one, so it's always a good one. Then you can check it's there, and then you can create it if it doesn't exist. That's going to be 60 by 160. 1600, isn't it? Level 160. Okay. Those 160. Okay, and if there's set target. Basically, just a completely new kit. You can then draw sprite index. Although that could be a global. If we're doing an initializer for the different level, we could set a global to that and then click through some of the sprites. And then that's it. Reset. Okay. So we now have our level and a sprite. And draw surface. There we go. Okay. For surface. Oh yeah, probably need to, like a location maybe. Okay. So that should be the surface now, not the background. Not the sprite. We can just check. I should get nothing. Hey! So we've got the surface. We've got the level on the surface. So once we have that. We want to use this command, which I can't remember if it's got to be a pre-created surface or not. Yeah, so I'll create size 1600 by 200, no, 160 because it's on the okay. Times 4. ARGB is the color stuff. So we need to have a buffer that's large enough. Buffer type. Let's forget these. Buffers, create. Buffer fixed. Don't need it to grow. Alignment, single byte. Okay, so that should be level mask. So that's where we're going to put our mask. Okay, so right from there into here. Zero. So that should copy that buffer. It'd be nice to be able to test that. How can I test that? 160. I could just print out some of the numbers. Ideally, I'll loop over it and get rid of the alpha component as well. Oh, it might be zero because we have cleared it to zero. Let's just suck it and see. So I just want to make sure I'm getting some of the bytes in, or the actual level in to the byte array. So we're going to use this as our mask that we're going to walk on. Plus, heap, level mask, comma, offset. So yy times 600 times 4 plus xx times 4. So that should give us a pixel. Type. This one's here. It'll be a 32-bit unsigned int that we want. Okay, so once we've done that, we can do show debug message. Okay. See what that does. Okay, that's not filling me through hope, full of hope. What have I done? Oh, I see what I've done. Stuck in an infinite loop because XX. There we go. Not quite what I was expecting. Oh, no. So plus. Try that again. Ideally, you print it as hex, but I really just need to see that it's getting going. There you go. Space at the top, and you can get the wave of the water there. So that's looking good. It's got solid alpha kind of values in it. If I take one of these and do a lookup. Oh, because it's the same value. Being blue. So if I show what that value is. There you go. So FF, and then that'll be a shade of blue, whatever that is, which is fine. So I can just comment this out. It's always handy to keep for test for just now. So we have that. What I can do is a quick test. Let me. Let me just in the room. Change the background color to something else. Just so we've got a bit transparent in it. And then we'll just do a little play with erasing. Alpha. This is where it gets interesting because you've got to start. Ideally, I want to use the GPU as much as possible to do all the masking stuff. I don't really want to get into having to do it all with the processor again, like we used to do. So Let me just a little think about this. So, I'll do a cursor as well. Create. Image. Now let's make that 16x16 as well. Actually, that should really be a. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay, fine. I can live with that. And origin map. Okay, so let's just put our level. that's in the options, isn't it? That's what I'm looking for. The Windows ones. Graphics. Yeah, cursor. No, thank you. So okay, let's just camera this. So object, let's put step event in, and we'll set the cursor this will deal with the cursor part. Type. Didn't actually name it. Oh, I did name it. Cursor, zero, comma, state, comma. Why? Oh, except that's not where that should be. That should be in the draw GUI. Yes. So I also want to set the GUI size. Size, which would be 20 by 200, I think. Let me just have a quick look and see what this looks like. Okay, that's kind of what you expect. Now then, the interesting part. Let's do mouse global mouse down. So first just need a flag. Okay, so draw. This is where it gets interesting. We've got to try and get the right blend mode to basically cut out that shape in the level. Set target surface. Set. Sprite. A masks. Why? Okay, let's see what that does. Hey, look, it draws just like you think. Okay, I'm doing middle mouse to scroll like I do in the UI. That might be a better way of scrolling in Lemmings than kind of the push scroll that we used to have. Just click the middle mouse and pull it about. It's probably a good idea. Okay, so now set it's changed now, isn't it? GPU set blend enable. That's true, I think it's on anyway, but set blend. And mode. No, subtractive might work because it's a kind of solid white thing. Let's see what that. Whoa! Okay, let's not do that. Let's put it back to where it was at the end. That's because you need to do that. Try that again. Ooh, there you go. Look at that. Instant removal. So that'd be like blowing something up. Pop. Okay. Now, the only thing with that is once we've done that, we need to kind of grab the buffer again so we can get the new mask. So that should just be copy it. Ideally, you'd copy the little bit, but I don't know if you can. Let's just do this just now. So I think we can look to get a lemming walk. Kind of want a background. Used to have some really cool backgrounds in Lemmings 2. Yeah, okay, I'm going to say, let's go. In 1 sec. Right, okay, so I've got that, and then Lemmings falling. That's what we want to do now. So, trapdoor. So, So a second just now. 30 a second. Funnily enough, Lemmings was not a 60 frames a second game. It was actually 17 frames a second in PAL and 15 in 15. No, I'm not. 60. 20 frames a second. So let's do 20. We'll do NTSC. It took 3 frames to do the whole thing. So this will actually keep the timing more or less the same. And blah, 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 blah. That's the counter. Let's stick it on the line. So I don't actually have to do any work myself. Oh, I see that. See that? Oh, the we've put that before where the just can't quite decide the size of something. Weird. So reset the timer. Let's make a specific liming layer, shall we? Which should probably be under other objects. Okay. So we'll spawn it at the origin point, and we are Lemmings. Lemming. Assuming that's what I called it. Oh, Lemming. There we go. I think we should give it a default. They always kind of come out falling, so probably want to give it the faller. Okay. Blah, 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 blah. So I'm not gonna do anything, they should just spawn and stick there. Hey, many of them. So I just want to have a number so I can count how many we're actually gonna be doing. Let's stick that as a global. And then the other thing can do it. So that can't. Let's create font, just any old thing just now. Yeah, whatever. And level jockey set font. Text, That's huge. You forget it was such low resolution, so even a small font is just ginormous on this. I don't have any nice small fonts. They're all kind of big and chunky, really. Although there is a bug just now that isn't generating these correctly. So that's going to look like. It's not quite right. But it's decent size, that'll do. Okay. Now it gets interesting. So. That's too big to type. Actually, just ELM is probably fine. And then we're going to go walker or follow. So, walker. What's the other guy? Parachute. What was it? Broly. Walker Broly. Walker. What did you say? Okay, so that actually down there that over that and that I don't need that for the moment, so let's just do that. Okay. Move them down just now. Move you down. Okay, step. Just come out. See, should just come out forward, but he's not. Not set. Forward reading. Forward. Oh. Duh. Hit. Dot forward. That goes for that as well, doesn't it? Okay. Hey. Blop, blop, blop. Okay. So now it comes interesting because now I've got to actually do some collision checks. So I'm going to create check collision. This should just return true or false whether there's a pixel there just now. So index. I did make that global, didn't I? The buffer? Level. I did indeed. Now this will definitely be set up by the time the lemming comes out, because he comes out a few frames later anyway. Which is fine. Index. And type. See, again, no idea what the type is. U32. False. So that will basically tell me if there's a pixel or not. Can't remember how fast the lemming fell. That's embarrassing. I wonder if Russell's on. He'd know. Four pixels. I want to do check collision. I got to that params thing earlier. Is it params? I'm assuming this is in the docs, let me just check. There we go. Param. X. I've just asked Russell, how far did the lemming fall? Was it 4 pixels? And he's just pinged me in Skype the assembly source code to a fallen lemming. Three pixels from that code. Okay, 3 pixels. 3 pixels it is. I can't believe you had that to hand. That was funny. I'm going to cut and paste that into the window because it's funny. So he just sent me this on Skype. That's just 3 pixels from that code. So there you go. Yes, we still have all the old codes from those days in a folder that we know of. But he's just sent me that. Oh, that's handy. He sent me all the process code. Okay, I'm going to try not to use that, but we'll give it a go. Oh dear. Break. So I just fall out, and then all of a sudden I'm going to change the state to be, oh for goodness sake, I think he's just sending me the source to Lemmings now. Oh, he's got C++ source, look at that. Okay. Oh for goodness sake. Oh dear, that amuses me. Okay, so state dot walker. So we'll just see what that does. Still can't go. Does the source to hand? That's funny. Y. Oops, still one. Ooh, look at that. Fall on land. Just like I bought one. So does that come from the IntelliSense then? Who does all that? No, it was x86, not 68k. So now I need to do the walker. So walkers, they need a direction, don't they? Hang on a sec. So I'm just going to bookmark this. So you see the bookmarks and stick them down, which means wherever I am, I can kind of jump back quickly. Equals for right, for left, and then I can bookmark this as well. Now I can just jump back and forward. So even if it's all the way up here, wherever, if I'm over here and I click my bookmarks, it takes me straight there. You should look at bookmarks, they are awesome. Okay, so collisions. I need curly brackets here, as we said. It's just a habit. Okay, so we want to. You actually do move into the block, I seem to remember. So what we're going to do is we're going to check up the way first to see if we have to jump up. I don't want to check down the way first. Plus four minus. Well, I could just do that actually. So we can start off at 4 and keep going to its less than 0, less than minus 4. That should be not actually, not about that. So that will come in. There you go. So that will come in. If the ground's here and the guy moves, we'll start checking there and then go back up negative. And that in one check will let me jump up or down. I don't know if that's the actual way it worked, but seems like a good idea to me. So if it's on flat, it'll add 0, it'll move up or down. Positive or negative 4. Less than 0, less than 2, 4. So less than equal to. Soon find out. Pop my count. 27. Because it hasn't been set in this one. Okay. Okay. Not exactly what I thought was going to happen. Oh, look at that. Let's change the mask though. Hey, badly, but okay. So check collision. Y plus 4 to y minus 4 is minus. I'm tempted to do is in the trapdoor just do one lemming. And then I can just dump out numbers as it goes, so I can see what it's actually doing. So 0, okay. Count 0. If collision checks. So see, that's false. Yeah, so it's true. You just break out the loop. Kind of tempted to try and plot the collision around the lemming so I can kind of see where he's going. Having a CPU buffer over a collision mask makes it a bit tricky to know what's in there, what you're actually checking. So I think what I want to do. Mm-hmm. it's just what we can do is in the creation, just nip this bit of code. As I said, that kind of code is usually handy to keep around. But what we'll not do is go from 0, we'll go from y minus 16 to y 16. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to give it a peek. Just do the collision check just now. X minus 16. Less than, I might have just got my loop, my comparison wrong actually. X plus 16. Blah 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 blah. Plus plus, that's fine. So draw point. X equals blah blah blah. 10. Check. Version. Set my Y. And draw a point. Py. X R Py. X plus. Okay, well, I missed. Squiggly brackets, curly brackets. Okay. So that should print a little 16 by 16 around where the Lemmings' feet are. I think. Just as points. Should be the missing size because I don't have that anymore. Let's do that. Which I'm not seeing. At all. Draw a set. Color. Night. Draw a set. Alpha. One. It's not just a point color. There it is. Right. The draw point functions are actually really fast. I don't know if you saw the emulator I wrote in GameMaker last Christmas. Yeah. But it built up all the retro graphics in caches using the draw point function. You're able to get thousands and thousands of pixels through. As long as they're drawn in a batch, then the hardware just blasts through them. X, Y, X, X, Y. That should be okay. Let's stick it down at the bottom. 160 by 170. It's in the draw, so it should be. I haven't seen anything. It's not. Tell you what. That's just that function can be totally broken. Okay. Okay, that's one. Oops, that's interesting, that just looks totally wrong. Points always an actual point, even though things scale up, it doesn't draw rectangles, so they'll never scale with everything else. So that looks like it's not working as I'd expect. there you go. Oh, yeah, it's not getting, it's just totally flat. It's not getting stuff around it. So what's wrong with this? Ah, so it's the X, not X. Let's try that. Hey! Okay. Just going to walk it up and down. You can kind of see it's, I don't know how he's working, but it's very cool. I like that. I see it all change as you draw things. That's really smart. That's very cool. Okay. So it's now getting that. Why it's not actually looping through is another matter, but at least it's kind of expected. Should be in the middle where the lemming is, obviously, which is probably about right. As it comes over here, that should fill up. Yeah, there you go. Cool. Okay, so this part must just be wrong. So it's maybe this. Actually, so I could just do -4. That's less than 4, and then go up one. Doing exactly the same. Ship it. Sound like Stuart Poole. Okay, it's not what I thought was going to happen either. So it starts at -4. Oh, it's less than it. That should be alright. How many pixels did it? It's still zeros. See, less than 10. I'm kind of a little confused with that. Or something. I haven't tried the debugger on this yet. See what happens when you get the debugger. Ooh. Look at that. So if I do split right type distance split below. Locals. So we've got count. And variables 1, 2, 9, 6. See -4. So it should be 1, 2, 6. Looks like it should be fine. It's fine. Big number. Okay. Plus 1, 2. Oh, hang on. I'm adding on count. Don't want to be adding on count. Count should start at -4 as well. Hurrah! Hey, look at that! Mm-hmm. Now you can ship it. So, just need the walking animation now. What I might do is just do a set state. Create set state. It's 1 hour, 12 minutes in. I've just about got a lemming walking. Hoorah. state equals 0 state. So on for, set the image, not sprite shape, sprite index equals explorer, that's all it is, isn't it? Set non-locker. Can do as well, depending on the direction. Then you'll at least flip the right way just based on that direction flag. Yes. Okay. There might be more things to set in there as we kind of go along, but that'll do just now. He's not animating right because he's sliding. Lemmings were very good at keeping their feet on the ground, and that comes from the position as the kind of frame that it's on. So we will have a special draw for the lemming as well. So there's just this draw self. Comment out for the moment. Actually not, because it's really cool. I want to see it. So, I'm getting telesense for what I did. Came up there. Just slow. Ooh, saw that. See if I can recreate that, hang on, because we were talking about this kind of bug today. Right, so it's not going up now. There we go. Follow up. See, it's doing it. Where's that in? 116. Yeah, just not at all. Just okay. Actually, one to four first, because that's... So that is just a case of draw sprite. Sprite. Index, comma, image, index, comma, let's go on. There's nothing particularly special about them. So, walker. Now, walkers are special. But there's a very special. So, we want to take the x, and the 7. So, the frame is the lower 0 to 8 of the coordinate. That should be x because we have image x scale, comma, comma, scale, comma, scale, white, comma, one. Let's copy that in. Oh, it's going to be worth taking all that in. Okay. Remember when we added draw self? Andrew in the office was just went mad over it. Weird in two of them because I have one up. Hopefully we get to a flat bit. You can see his feet stick perfectly onto the ground. I can still see where he's walking over. I need to get the dragon in, that's what I need to do. That's really cool. Oh, the hell's that? I need to do them flipping around as well. So, in Lemmings, if he hits a wall, four pixels vertical or whatever, I might have to do that in two bits actually, come on, minus, because that would be a wall in front of you, then the lower pixels wouldn't matter, but you might still be finding space. Oh, I'm just checking zeros. So, if there's anything. No, that doesn't work because there could be a few pixels up there and tiny little gap, and Lemmings would walk through that. So, actually, you have to check up and then check down. Someone also sent me the code to this. I'm not sure what he did. Well, I'm going to do it from memory. This will do for the moment, but I'll get back to it. Don't need that now. So, four. So that's basically hit a wall. Turn around. So I'm going to do that, negate it. And then flip around. And then we'll see if we can draw in a little wall. Oh, he's going to fall. Bugger. Might do it. Hey, there you go. Oh, his X is not quite right. If he's gone left, you need to flip the frame thing so he sticks to the ground again. Otherwise, his frames are a bit backwards. I love this little thing at the bottom. simple things. That's very cool. Cool. So that's a box, let's undo that. Let's put the scrolling in, because the scrolling's a bit, I can't see the whole level. So I kind of want to be able to pan around. And let's take the artificial thing out of there. Looks like before I stop that, I'm going to take the debug out as well. I can't have a million of them all written up, which is a pain to me because it's very cool. Okay, so now we should start to get multiple. Hey, just like I bought one. So I want to be able to grab the background. Oh, look, they have to turn around in there. Let's just smooth the path. So before I do that, let's fix the draw. So and it's less than zero, then I think it's 7-. Just flip it over basically for the frames. Yeah, that looks better, doesn't it? Yep, feet 6 solid. That's good. They still look really cool, I have to say. I'm going to post a picture of that because it's very cool. Screenshot Saturday, but hey, what the hell. Still something vastly satisfying by having all these lemmings. It's very weird. Even after all these years. What's that? Let's see how long it's taken me to actually get them walking properly. 1 hour 26 minutes to have the background taking bits out, lemmings walking about. That's pretty cool. That took us ages, weeks before. Okay, that's the problem with this kind of stuff. It's, whoa, what the hell has happened there? You've just been, okay, I don't know quite why that happened. It's just kind of maximized the view. It's a bit weird. I pressed the key by accident. I don't know if you actually saw that or if it was just, I'm waiting for the stream to catch up to see if it gets the same thing. Yeah, the problem with doing anything coding that you think's cool is just you spend all your time just looking at it, utterly fascinated by what's going on. So I want to scroll the level now. Scroll level. So let's do mouse middle down. Global middle down, that's what I'm going to do. I missed it. Did the screen go huge? Did it? Yeah, it looks like it did. I don't know why it went like that. Sorry to force my face on you. That's what happened. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna press the middle. If it's not scrolling, we'll go and initiate scroll. I just want to do that in the step event. Step begins fine as well. And then we'll do just a button down. Which is all this is going to set. And that can be reset each frame. I could do mouse down, mouse up, but that's just a pain. Scroll down, and that. So that's basically, it's not start scrolling yet, but the button's down. Then start scrolling, do that. It's not up, the button's not down, but it has started scrolling. Now basically just want a, if it's down, kill that, and kill that. Yeah, it's recorded anyway, you can go back and watch it if you're that bored. I will upload all these onto YouTube at some point. I don't know when. I've got about six of them to do. I kind of recreated kind of Arkanoid style game breakout stuff. And then I did a Manic Miner remake past couple of nights, which are on the videos here. But again, I will upload them onto YouTube at some point. Right, so we've got that. Oh, this is where it gets interesting now, because I've got to work out how cameras work. Because I draw everything myself, I could have a global camera and just subtract the values off. It would make no difference whatsoever. I don't really need a camera. I don't actually need the room to be that big either, I have to say. It could just be a single screen. I am curious how cameras work, because I haven't used them yet. Position. Okay. So I need to have the anchor where it was, and I need the current world position, and get view x. Is there a default camera? And get default. Okay. Strikes me I should have that as a variable somewhere and not do it all the time. But hey, I'm a lazy sod. If you want, blah, 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 blah. So while we're scrolling, if we're scrolling, then so set equals global minus x. So that would be 0 minus to drag over there. 10, yeah, that's probably right. Now we want to do camera set position. It's not camera set position. Setters. Camera set view course. Okay, hang on. Have I done that wrong? Is there a get pos getters viewx? I'm getting wrong. Okay, I'm not quite sure I'm getting this right. I don't have anything to do with the new camera stuff. So that I should find out if it's totally crazy. Whatever it was, actually I'm not changing the Y at all. I don't know why I'm getting the Y. I'm going monkeys out of Y. I'm only scrolling that left and right. It is not Lemmings 2, it is Lemmings 1. We have no vertical scrolling. That keeps going down a little bit. Although I probably do need to get it because I'm set in position, which is annoying. Okay. I don't have anything fancy with it, so that's fine. Why is that coloured differently? I doubt if I run it and it crashes, it'll tell me. That's almost right. Almost. Oh, no, hang on, because that's drawn way off to the side. What the hell? Okay, yeah, not quite right. Yeah, okay, that's weird. Does anybody use cameras? I should really fiddle with cameras outside of this so that I can actually know what I'm doing. Actually, I've not actually done anything with them. Can I get active? Oh, can we get default? Can we get default? View camera. So why would that be? Don't add that on. What's it do? So I don't copy and cut it out. Because that's clever. That should just set the same thing and not scroll. Which is absolutely fine. X, and then this gets the delta between them. I think it's supposed to be backwards. I think it's, the way I've got it's probably right. Juddering like that, although the res is going to be wrong, isn't it? Because it's three times the size. One of us should take that for it first. Because everything's scaled up, the mouse movement's going to be a bit funny. That's better, but it's so there. Mouse X is supposed to be. Is it mice X? Well, mice X is supposed to be to the scale of. I don't know where that is. Now I'm going to find out. Draw it! The offset as well. It's kind of thing I hate with game dev, just a little fiddling to stuff works. Strings around these as well, and then the offset. FX as being instead FX have been defined nowhere because I'm an idiot. Point 202. Why is Jedline? Must be the mapping down. There is a device X, isn't there? Where you can actually get the real value. Display. Display get mouse X. It gives me the value relative to the display. So let's try that one. Oh, hang on. There is a raw get mouse X. Oh, try display one first, that may be enough. And that one may be out by factor of three, because I think this is from the origin of the thing. I don't like it. Let's put this backwards then. That's from the origin of the desktop. It's probably a better thing to draw with as well, as we said. It doesn't kind of clap when it goes out. So I'm on 4. Okay. Fiddly, fiddly, fiddle. Still going backwards. Why are you going backwards? So it's minus 3, why is it going to the right? This is a camera, you need to reverse. No. That's just confusing me. It's the same value, the same. So moving left is moving the mouse right. Actually, no, ignore the cursor. It is actually panning the way it should pan. It's the cursor wrong. Okay, so the cursor. Obviously using the wrong function there. Don't know quite what that's going to do, I have to say. I might have to scale this down. Yeah. Can you get the window position? And we'll get... Oh, you can. So let's do under X, under Y, and then X, and it's the window X, and it's window Y. Hang on, that's total rubbish. Put it down there. I messed up there as well. Well, here, what? Oh, same points. Okay. Okay. There you go. So it feels very fast, but that's totally wrong drawing now as well. What I may do is actually do this in the beginning step as well. Actually, just set the convinced that's I'm not going to need to add on minus camera as well. I think. Draw use that to actually draw. I could probably just draw that thing over the top actually, could so I could see. Oh, there you go. Oh, no, it's not offsetting, is it? Where's it? Oh, it's way over there. Okay. No, see, that's not right, is it? That's right, but feeling it needs to be scaled down. What I will do is basically try and draw a sprite to that position so I can kind of see where it's going to be. It's not going to mask it out or anything, it'll just be drawn on top. Then I can see it, how it's going to drift. And then I can use these values and all this stuff, just make it a bit simpler. I'm still convinced I should be scaling this down somehow, because it feels very fast moving in there. Let me just see how it anchors. So it's way over there for some reason. Yeah, see, it's way over to the edge. It needs scaled down. So that should be over 3, I think. I'm not drawing that same thing or not. See that zero minutes. Moving out. Drawing a spell there. What is it? Of course it's not been drawn, is it? No. Do and why that's there. Come on, I think I've got that wrong. Less divided by 3. And then you take the camera off. Okay, the ball's right, the cursor's wrong. So that's fine. So now, in draw GUI, I can actually use the value I've just worked out. To draw my cursor. Right. Whoa. That's totally off again. Okay, I think that's because the camera position is not worked out right. Because it looks like it's fine here. Oh, it's kind of getting all that, but as soon as you scroll it, they're kind of getting offset in that sync. One's drawn in the room and one's drawn on top of the GUI, so one's in the world, one's not. Okay. So by definition then that should be so the one that's on top of the GUI as well. Yes. Okay. That's on the GUI. I don't want to deal with the world at all. I just want to take a basic calculation. And then use that. Oops. Cut and paste king. Okay, so that's now. And that's correct. So there. So now I just need to get the bloody camera one set up properly. It's drifting, not in the world, it's just drifting away off to the edge. Cameras are always fun. So GUI's right, camera's wrong. So it's got to be something to do with this view camera thing. Because this calculation here is right in terms of getting the position in the window. So I could just take that out here and do that and make that global so that the thing can draw it, and then I can use that in my calculation because I know that part's right. So I can go global dot, oops, dot. Let's just get the calculations together. Right, so now I know this is correct. That be plus because the camera's a position in the room and it kind of scrolls. So yeah, that would make more sense. That's why plus X, blah 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 blah. Okay, try that. So anchored. Bit of a funny lag on it. But it's sticking. That is alright. I don't know why it's doing that line, that's a bit weird. Is it got that lag? It's bizarre. However, oh, where the hell did you come from? Why did I get lemmings coming off of there? Okay, that's weird. Just gonna watch my little the feed's about 20-30 seconds behind, so got a bug. I'm just waiting for it to reappear on my feed so I can actually see it, because I'm convinced some mod went on there. The lemmings were off the left hand side of the map. Right there, it's fine, it's all good. Pan back. Oh yeah, look, there's lemmings there. Where the hell did they come from? But they're on the map. Which means some lemmings must have gone negative somehow. Which is super weird. Oh, hang on, let's see what happens there. Just drop. So that's the other state I've got to do. I've got to do followers, where if they get the -3 and or -4, then they turn back into a follower, and then they should be following what big distances. Which means if I did that, kind of sheer face that, they should be following again. So I need to do that. Yeah, there must be a state where the lemmings went negative for some reason. Maybe when they flipped round or something. But I'm not exactly sure either. Because it just, you know, adds on a direction. So I don't really know how it can get more. -4 + +4. So, -4 and set state for so that will just they'll change back into a follower and carry on. So if I smooth it up to here, then do a big cliff thing, and they should start to fall. But they're not. They're ignoring me completely. Let's go to 4. You should be doing that. Why don't you do that? Let me just switch. And they learn to type. Oh, for goodness sake. Show debug message. Debug message. I need to take my bloody brackets off. It's just annoying. So again. No, not a thing. Let's go and set us back to one lemon again. And let's just output and see what it is. So -1, -2, -1, -5. Okay, that was weird. So it turns back and forth. The other one obviously is splatter. When they fall, it's a third of a screen. Which would be 53 pixels. I think it was 60 pixels. But I can tell you because on that level, the first. Oh, I've taken that away. I still have the level up here. Let me just bring this back. What have you just done? Okay, that was weird. Okay, 53. In this level, when they fell that distance, they splatted, which is why you had to build up there, but they only splatted by just a little bit. So 53 is probably right. So what we'll do is we will move the camera over to where this trapdoor is. And just copy, so I've got I can get the trapdoor placed properly. Oh, so we're there. Okay, don't need that at all, and I need that in because I sneakily kept the trapdoor. This is one of my levels that I made. I used to make pretty pictures out of them. Kessel, I'm trying to remember where Kessel, it was Kessel Run or something, wasn't it? Star Wars reference. Steel Mines of Kessel then. You got Island of the Wicker People, which was a Batman reference. So why stir that? Just open the room. You can use P, press P, you can pick, it'll find what it is and it'll pick it for you. Stick that there, and I can go back, just hide that, and then it just kind of magically fixes everything up. So now what I want to do is I want to center that, the room around this view. So now I know how cameras work. I can just close that again, don't need that. So I can do camera set pause. So on create, I can set the camera to be, it's in the middle. So let's see. 60. And I should set it. So we're there and then across a bit. Hey. And the lemmings are underneath the level. That's not what I want. Lemmings were never underneath the level. That's because it's in there. So let's just move that down, bring them up to level, and then do another one, which is objects, so traps and stuff. I've got a feeling lemmings were over the top of everything, but we'll do that just now. That's better. That's much more lemming-like. It really is still very satisfying seeing them do that. Was it tough? To get up there. Hey! You should go down and get blocked. So, falling 53 pixels. He should die. So, and then in our set state, just zero. In process, isn't it? In process. So if it hits the ground, middle click, it'll go to enums, by the way. Super handy. So now we've got to do splatter. So this is just an animating object, then he just dies. End of the frame. Splatter. Edge. these will be 16 by 10s. Turn that into an animation. Cat frames, did I? Don't. 16, I'm guessing. All right. Yep. Blah. Cool. Okay. So we just make sure that the origin's set in this. Then we know the other ones are. Just lovely. And then inside the code, set state. Don't need to do anything particular for that. And just in the lemming, let me draw him. And we don't take into account any scale. He has no direction. Destroy. Okay, I know that's going to do. Let's find out. Oh, okay, let's make it. I've not maybe got the offset quite right for the trapdoor. So for the sake of just checking, let's just make it if it's over that. Hey! Oh, got to take away the black background. Splatter. Yeah. So. Okay, so let's take away the trapdoor limit again. We'll speed them up a little bit too. Get some out. Blah. Need the panel up, that's what I need. I should put in the drawing as well. We'll draw hills. Black mouse button arrays. That's a good idea. I feel a bit of ideas today. What was that? Was that on level? Left down, start doing things. Left button pressed. Advent. Mouse. Right. Draw. Create. Stand. Left down. Left down. Stair. Left down, right down. So here's the draw. So right button press, you take away. Left button pressed. You draw. That just means don't do any of the blend mode stuff at all. I'll just buy it, copy it back again. That's it done. Okay. Why is it scaling the image when I draw into it? Weird. What's it doing that? That's very strange. They should. There was a thing about them just climbing up and kind of making their way out. Funny. I wonder if I can find some of the Lemmings music as an MP3. I could have that playing in the background. I just noticed I missed a pixel there. Just trying to undo painting. How stupid is that? Okay. Oh, I don't need that, but we'll leave it there. It was growing the image, stretching the image when I was pressing the middle mouse button. That's very strange. It's not that point. As you scroll it, it kind of fixes it. It's almost like the coordinate in the room is not, the instance just isn't quite right. It's 0, 0. That's what you'd expect. I'm also going to change this background color black to black now that we kind of know it works. I really want to get the panel up. You know, I don't think I've got panel graphics. I need to go and find some. Here we go. Screenshot. Oh, you got the mini map as well, don't you? Forgot about that. Yes, that's true. Still have that mini map. 200. Scaled, that's not right. Mega one wasn't 200, was it? It's 320.256. No, it wasn't, it's 200. Why is that scaled? I don't have any music on this whole time. I wonder why it's so quiet. Your panel. 6,400. It's doubled. Fucking doubled in size. There's one. Image. Save. Why is all the 320-200 images scaled? Because it probably come from an emulator and been shrunk down. This is most annoying. Okay. Oh, Lemmings 2. I like the panel in Lemmings 2, it was nice. So that's just a screenshot, 644-18 and then we'll. Oh, shrink it down. As long as the panel's 1:1, then it's fine. Image resize 50%. Middle. You're not giving me a mode. That's crop. That's why. Image resize. Best crop. And we've got pixel. Just neighbor. 50. Better. Right, so quit image. Okay. One panel. This up though, of course. Okay. We actually plotted the lemmings as well in the minimap. Ooh, okay. That's interesting. I know that the minimap did change. You got the holes and stuff in it and things like that. Okay, this will do just now. I just want something to print so I can get the kind of feel for it. Level draw GUI. Let's just disable that drawing for a moment. And draw a sprite. Okay. Ooh, look at that. It's amazing what difference the panel makes, doesn't it? Now I can generate that minimap. How can I do that? Again, rather use the GPU so that it's every time we modify, I can just take a chunk out of it. From memory, it's about a quarter the size. So it's like every 4 pixels or something. Right in there. What size is it? 100 by 20. Oh, geez, okay. 60 by 20. 8. Oh, it's only 8. 100. 16 by 8. So each pixel is a 16 by 8 cell of collision. Okay, how can I do that? I can scale the. Oh, I could do that. So here's a sneaky way of doing it. What's the coordinate within there? 60, 200. Yeah. So the coordinate of it is 208 by 178. Okay, so first, let's draw surface stretched oval dot oval surface, and that 208 by 178, and then that is going to be, I said, 100 by 20. By 20. Okay. So what does that look like? Ooh, look at that. Okay, I really need to just erase that, don't I? The actual map from the panel. Now, I should really take out all this as well, so it's using the background colour, which is what the Mega did. Right, so yeah, the Amiga, all the blacks were basically the background color. And then these were transparent. Okay, So I have to fill the bottom part with black now. And oh, there we go, still there. So there you have a level. So if I start carving bits away on this, hey presto, it kind of changes in real time. So how to get it green? Well, it's a sneaky level. It's in the level I'm doing, isn't it? Yes. GPU set fog true, comma, send bar green, comma, 0.0. Oh, no, hang on, that's not what I want to do. And once I've done it, I'm going to switch it off again. Yay, look at that. So again, it just gives me a green thing. I'm going to be uploading it onto YouTube at some point. Don't know when, but I'll do it at some point. So yeah, instant minimap. And all using a GPU. I'm not actually having to process it in software at all. Which is great. Now it has to be said, unlike Lemmings, I could put a parallax background in this. So let's try and figure out where the lemming should drop from. Because that will tell me where I should be drawing. Where is it? Levels. Where the offset of the trapdoor should be. Because just now it's just at the very base, but that's only 49. 1, 2, so 1, 2, 3. So a couple of pixels above. 1 pixel above there, I think. Trapdoor. Yeah, so 1. I think there. Let's just see if we can get the get back to 53. Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? Oh, because I didn't disable that. Okay. So let's move it up one more. I'm pretty sure it was 53. It was about a third screen. Oh. That's not how, that's just moving this down. I need to move that. That's stupid. So I'm not, I need to move it up in the room to compensate for. Up in there and just to compensate for those few pixels I've moved. Hey! There you go! So, it'd be nice to get the water in, wouldn't it? Just get them in as objects. I need to cap the movement as well. I don't know if I've got the water sprites, you know that. Let me just check my... I don't think I've got any of the object sprites. I only had the animations. Damn. They were all drawn. They look like they might be... No, it looks like the same frame. Yeah. That's annoying. Not having the water. It'd be nice to see the water move. I only ever did the Lemmings animation. I didn't actually have any of the other ones. Okay. Never mind. Right, so I'm also not sure what the selection cursor was. I thought it was just a yellow box, but I'm not quite sure of that now. Oh no, it was a kind of a lemon cursor. It was a weird one, wasn't it? Little 2x2, oh god, yeah. So... the lemon cursor was actually a 16x16 sprite. It's a hardware sprite, which is why it moved smoothly over the whole thing. So I'm already 16x16. I am, right. So it was actually something like this. Is it 3 or 4? 3. White. So it was like a thing, okay. And then that. That was the Lemmings. Oh. This is a PC one, must be said. Use different frames for the cursors, don't need different sprites. We want to green that dark, I have to say. Ugh. I wonder if there's a screenshot with the Lemmings cursors in it. Open on the other screen just so I can kind of see. It's scaled as well. Images are always scaled. What an Amiga means. The proper cursor. 6400. That's 480, it had to be. That was pretty crisp. Okay, so on the Amiga, it was luminous green and dark green. kind of like that. Except having two. Do I have two things open on that? You are too dark. There's actually yellow in the middle on the radar, not blue. How'd you know? Confused. Still don't think that's the right colour. That's the colour. All very different. Very different. Okay. Yep. Yeah, along the middle. Now the selection one. So I'm just going to delete and copy paste that. So I need to find a screenshot where it's picking a lemming on the Amiga, which is harder than it seems. It's a lot harder than it seems. Bloody hell. It's almost just the cursor floating and loads of lemmings moving. Very little in the way of actual selections. Yes. Oh, there we go. Perfect. Copy image. And that just again. Paste that. So it was. Oh, what the hell's happened there? Oh, I had the layer, of course. I just want that one there for reference just now. More so I can get colours from it than anything else. So, selection one was kind of like this, I think. I just did that. Hang on. Okay, I've done that backwards now. Right. Doing that. Okay, it's easier. Okay, so two cursors. Well, that was harder than it should have been. Yep. So get rid of that little white ball for the moment. which is in level draw. This one. And for the moment, let's also get rid of code that kind of adds and removes backgrounds. Because I want to start selecting lemmings. Click. So now, I basically want to do a little binding box check with the lemmings so that when they go into the cursor, I can change what cursor I'm using. It's the cursor drawn. Yeah. Okay, so my sex is the position in the room. So step ends, let's do, because then they would have all moved back. In the middle, so close y is less than, so lemming is about, how many pixels is a lemming wide? One, two, three, so six in total, I guess. Where was I? Level, wasn't it? That's the six. And why? So I want to move it up so it's in the middle of the line. And then subtract off the y, and then that should be less than five. If I have that, then we've got started. True. Let's clear that each time. So I just want the cursor to flash if the lemming's going underneath it. So, cool. Oh, cursor is underneath the panel. That's not what I want. Droppy cursor should be over the top of everything. Actually, there's a GUI end as well, isn't there? Really? The cursor should be there. Because if I do other things, in the GUI stuff and different objects, it's still going to be over the top. So where are we? That's almost 3 hours worth. Okay. So we have a level. We have lemmings falling, dying. That's not bad for 3 hours. And we've got the add and remove background stuff as well. We know that works, which is quite cool. Just wondering if the faller guy should be above, because he's actually just pixels over the top. I'll just have a look at that a second. Yeah, he should be there. Splatter, not faller. Ah, much better. Now, metal collision is going to be tricky. On the Amiga one, it was basically binding. You had rectangles that you stretched over things, and that defined an area as solid. That's going to be tricky. These are just bitmaps. On the special levels, we didn't have any metal because it was like this. It was just a big image, and you just have to build your way through it. But all the other levels, it was like deep paint. You had big brush things, like our editor as well. Brushes, you just put down up to 512 of them to make a picture, and then you had these rectangles just stretched over the top of everything. I really want to find all the objects so I can get the graphics from them. I do have a whole of the graphics from Lemmings, so I might go raking later on tonight to see if I can find them. I get the trapdoor opening and the like the exit, maybe fire burns and stuff, and then I get the water as well, because that'd be really cool. I do love this drag scroll, so it's much better. Although I'm not convinced it's at the right speed, because that cursor should be attached to it, because you're kind of grabbing it with the hand. It kind of feels alright, but it doesn't look right. Okay. You also have the timers and stuff we have to do. I obviously don't have the fonts for them either. I'll need to try and find all that stuff in various archives, which will be interesting. I think the first thing we'll do is we'll assign a floater. Once you've got it and if you click while you're on it, select him. Make off, I could probably do it just now, so that's not going to take terribly long. Let's let's just quickly, he says. Oh, there's a kind of bringing it out animation, bringing the Brawly out animation, and then there's the while it's there animation. So there's two steps to this. There's a pre-floater and a floater. So we'll do the pre first. They look like 16 by 16, do they? Yes, they are. Okay. Do that. So it doesn't matter. Is this convert to frames kind of does it for you anyway? It's only four. 16, there you go. It's a super powerful tool if you've not used it, by the way. So that brings it out. And then there is a wondering if I'm going to run out of sprites, because I am using the free one, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I've still got a good stack of sprites left. Masks and stuff can use frames of panel. Technically speaking, I could put all the lemmings in one sheet and then just do my own animation. Don't particularly want to do that. I've got two bitmaps, one for solid and one for diggable. I could do a different collision map. It wouldn't change, of course, because it's metal, so you're not supposed to be able to dig in that. So yes. Problem is the GPU rendering. I'd have to do a shader so that I could use that map and not alter. So if you did the explosion and you've got that round explosion blob that cuts out, I need to have access to that so that I can drop out pixels that is in metal. And you need a shader for that, and you don't get shaders in the free one. Otherwise, you've got to do it with CPU. I don't think I can. I could blat it over the top again. I'm not sure how fast that would be, though. I'm not particularly worried about metal stuff at the moment. All the metal was I think to stop you from digging into it, because it was a CPU. And then it would do the collision check, and when you hit metal, you would change from a miner or digger or whatever back to being a walker again. And that was all that was really there. So the don't draw part and they have hit that, go and do something else part. So I'm not overly worried about that just now. So let's finish this floater guy. Don't need that. Floater 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the animations. Okay, don't need to, because it's frames 4, 16, 16. Okay. So floaters just went down at a pixel at a time. Does GameMaker let you do kind of two? Floater, that's what it's called. I didn't even think about it. I got the name right. Floater, pre-floater. So I don't know if GameMaker lets you do two cases at once like that and do a fall through. Suck it and see. Yeah, I don't really want to get dragged in too much. So photos are just single pixels, so don't need to count. I just need to check that. In fact, I don't really need to do that, just to move it down, and then when it's in a pixel, so If it's doing it, then change state to a walker. That's pretty much it. Now, how far did a floater fall before? A faller fall before becoming a floater. So let's just add some skills. I'll just make more floaters. Pause, why not? Let's just say 20. Floater state. I'll do that because it's set it, and then if so that's hit. So actually, let's just let's not hit the ground, then set the floor. So set state. So again, on if it's a floater sprite, we'll need to change the animation. On animation then, we immediately go to just the cyclic floater animation. Floater. Yes, floater. So we're going back to the lemming animation end. So if it's a splatter, it dies. If sprite index equals floater, then sprite index equals pre-filter. Image index equals, so start that again. Bound to be something wrong with that, so let's just see what happens. Oh, offsets are wrong. Not change the net, but aside from that, looks alright. So they again, offset should be just at the feet. That's where all Lemmings offsets are. Whoa, look at that. Should they actually touch them? I wonder if should his does the kind of change size? I wouldn't have thought so. I would have thought they should have still been. Oh, that looks better. Whoa, look at that. That's just very cool again. So the next one to do after this is Climber. Climber is, they come to something that's too tall. Instead of turning around, they just start to kind of walk up the wall until they hit something else, at which point they kind of go over the lip and carry on. That way you can kind of get over most of these shapes, as we said. They will hit the head on these. At that point, you turn them around, you turn them into followers, and then they start walking the other way. Okay, that is a 3 hours, 10 minutes session. I will pick this up. In theory, I've got another 7 hours that I could do this in. The idea of the game in a day stuff is you have to make it within 10 hours. Under 10 hours is what I'm aiming for, to see how much you can do in GameMaker Studio 2 in a very short time. Can you recreate core mechanics of a game? So we're doing quite well with this one. We've got Now we've got the basics. Walkers, fallers, floater. I'll do climber tomorrow. I thought the guys had yellow umbrellas for some reason. I'm just going to sneakily check. They do. Why am I in red? Did we change them? Looking at a screenshot and it's yellow brawlies. But the images I've got are red. And I'm not overly sure why. Unless... that can't have been a final sheet. That's interesting. I'm just going to change them because that's bad. So yellow. That's a bit luminous, though, I have to say. Let me just. I don't think it's quite as luminous. Oh, it is luminous. Jeez, okay. Okay, pre-floater and then floater. Okay. So now should be right. Okay. Right. I may do more of this tomorrow. We'll see what I'm doing tomorrow night. I will ping out maybe a wee bit beforehand that I'll be picking it up again. Okay. Night night, peeps.